Away, homies. Welcome to another episode of Super Skoon Conversations. For this episode, we have like an exciting guest. Actually asked us to come collect some of his sneakers. Quite a few. We got them cleaned. So today we'll be like taking them back to him, getting his reaction. And then we'll be heading straight to his studio. Away. No correlation for that conversation. Lately niggas in your up and learning imitation. We the youngest in the building, don't get in your feelings. Ain't got time for all that crap talking, we don't take it all, yo. Problem is I got many problems I can never solve. Why they hate? Cause they can't debate the boy on, cause they just get pissed off. Plug card me.
Okay, Okmalumkoolkat, Inkunzi, Malanga, Onke. They wait on my album, the 5G. Follow my stories on IG. Yeah. Sipping on cocoa and iced tea. Chase on my address, IP. Wow. I was surfing Indonesia. I never needed no visa. They hated, they got an amnesia. Baba, they nanya my skiza. Tell us, I do that, sabiza. Drip, sip it, score up. Sip it, score up. Drip, drip, sip it, score up. Sip it, score up. Drip, drip, sip it, score up. Sip it, score up. Drip, drip, sip it, score up. Drip. Peek at the top at the pinnacle. Wow. Something is beautiful. I'm in the cloud, I'm ahead of you. I'm unavailable. Wow. You need to find me in the aerial. We at the top, we imperial. When I was driving, like, where were you? You hold the L, I will W. I'm really here to empower you. I made some cash in the avenue. I understand I ain't double it. I'm really one with the element. You shouldn't build me a monument. Just cause I'm fresher than anime. Shambhala than Kalinan. I made a different material. I defecate on the stereo. Oh, I'm in your face like Emilio. I'm a big dog, I'm a Labrador. No, it's too soft, I'm a terrier. Hey, came with the gang, so we marry ya. We bring the vibe in the area. Spoke with the gang as superior. Yeah, we're superior. I think I came as a medio. I be Hakimi or Senio. I have no boundaries, no barriers. Took me a trip to Nigeria. I'm in a club with a Perrier. I had a dinner in Zanzibar. Life is a bitch and I married her. I woke up drunk in the Drakensberg. Cook in the kitchen like Heisenberg. Hangover Cupid to Haagen-Dazs. Smoking a cabbage like Adidas. I was just laughing with hyenas. I had a chat with a zebra. Told me about earning my stripes. I told him whatever. He was just sipping a Sprite. You couldn't write a recite. Must be the dung on the pipe. I'll just sip.
Okay, Okmalumkoolkat, aka Fijambana, aka Spant Mumbara, aka Mlazi Milano, aka Don Spovington, aka Apeda, my aka. But yeah, man, you know the rest. Out here with Super School. They just did like an impossible job. Like, this is like James Bond shit, man. Mission Impossible 2, for real. Like, yeah. I can't wait to start like dropping gems about these shoes.
Cool. So yeah, Usme just like asked us to
Usme being me, by the way.
Yeah, okay. he asked us to work on like a few of his sneakers and get them washed. He gave us quite a few. I think it was how many pairs?
26
pairs,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It took some time because we had to make sure that they're all clean. But we're just here to get a background, mm-hmm. and just to get some insight from you and like what's the whole idea with having so many sneakers and what's the love, you know, what's the whole inspiration behind them, because they're very different. And
Man, I would say I'm an accidental sneakerhead because I used to work for a sneaker store. Started working at Nike in 2008 at the Gallery on 4th, kind of like the first concept store in South Africa for like shoes. Well, there were a couple others, but like proper Joburg vibes, you know what I mean? And then we ended up doing energy marketing for Nike Sportswear South Africa. So I kind of got the disease from that time, because this thing is a disease, brother.
Yeah, it's kind of funny getting the disease from Nike and then falling in love with white.
Yeah. Well, I love a lot of brands, man, but it's like Yoji Yamamoto. I was following Yoji Yamamoto because I got into streetwear from college days. This is like 2003, before I went to college, I was already into streetwear.
I wanted to know why we were like washing and like cooking. What's the oldest pair like from all of these?
I'd say these one
the grey ones are hiding and stuff.
These are one of the oldest too. Like all the OG MX heads know about this drop. What was the shoe? What was that other shoe with the air trainer?
Yeah.
Yeah. So they mixed the air trainer with the MX1 here.
Even flipped up the undersole. And I saw the pattern.
Yeah, it's different. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But yeah, it was quite a crazy year for MX.
They were
trying this fly wire.
Yeah.
A technology that I don't like. Like you could stand in the sun for like maybe two times
and it yellows.
Like no matter how fresh.
These, did you cop them while you were still spending at Melbourne?
Yeah. This dropped. Oh, this dropped. Yeah.
Kickstarter.
Yeah. Well, it was free. It was free. Shout out.
Yo.
I can literally show you maybe three shoes that I bought here from all of this.
I feel their names all in the tree.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But yeah, man. Like, shout out to Nike, man.
Yeah.
Keep them coming.
Yeah, man. For someone who's a dancer and a sneakerhead, right? I honestly think of you like a walking dichotomy. Because
yeah,
I hate creases in shoes. Like me, I'll iron it. I'll put a wash rag on and get it. But you just like, pay no mind. I saw you ripping these up in Nigeria, yo. Yo, yeah. And I mean, these are the only white threes I've seen with like the ultra boost technology. How did you even get your hands on these?
Actually, shout out to Palazzo PT. I have a relationship with them. Okay. They're out in Hyde Park in Sandton, so they've got I just went to the store now. They've got Sandal Boys. You know the Sandal?
Yeah.
They just got those in.
You know, I only ever saw them on. Do you watch Round Two?
Yeah, Round Two, yeah.
Yo. Yo, and the one guy is like all Stephen Hawking.
They're there, bro.
And okay, cool, since we covered the oldest, the favorite. Like, yo, these are the shoes that must be on your feet in your casket.
Ah, shit. Do I even have a pair like that, bro? I feel like every week, I'm super bipolar when it comes to shoes and shit, man. Like, because even with the combos, like today, I'm feeling like this guy. I don't know who he is, but this is me today. You know what I mean?
Feeling
like this guy.
Coach.
But tomorrow I can come through in like maybe a Hugo Boss jacket and Hugo Boss pants, like office pants.
Yeah.
And then maybe these or like Sabagos or like penny loafers. You know what I mean? Like, so I just feel different every day, man. Like, so I don't have a favorite. And I hate to choose, really, because all my babies, really.
But speaking on streetwear, whilst you're on that point, for me, I think the projects we've been working on lately for streetwear, they've been crazy. I think the moves, like, I think you used a lot of imagination.
Yeah.
Like with like the drops for on Shambok Studios.
Yeah.
Like I saw the surfboard.
Even the Spova game merch.
Yeah, the Spova.
Yeah.
The business cards, bro.
Yeah.
He brought round corners back.
A little too much.
Actually, the guy who designed that he works here at Electromod.
It's dope.
So we just work together. Like I do a lot of creative direction. So I have the idea, have the references. I'm like super crazy with presenting the idea to the guy. And I'm lucky to find the right guys to just execute it and take it to the next level all the time.
So when we got in touch with you initially, I was actually, I saw you driving and I was on a bike, you know?
Yeah.
And I was like, yo, man, you have to work, you know? And then you're like, I definitely shoot me a text, whatever.
Sure.
But the crazy thing about the streetwear is that you actually created bikes and like you did like a raffle.
For,
correct me if I'm wrong, Yokuz and Spov again.
It was so we got people to subscribe.
Yeah.
Obviously, like we're growing this website, like Shambok Studios. It's quite crazy. It's like I've always been independent, right?
Yeah.
But there was no company. So there was no company.
Yeah.
Now it's like there's a company, and all the stuff I've done belongs to that company.
Sure.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then what we're fighting with now is trying to grow Shambok Studios to be bigger than Okmalumkoolkat, but obviously that's impossible overnight.
Yeah.
So it's like engaging with people more, and then also just like having a base where people can see all the stuff that we do, and also for people to understand that when I say, yo, we design this, or it's not just me, like I probably came up with the idea, but
team.
Yeah, there's always a team, yeah. You know what I mean? And I don't have one team, but I collaborate with like a lot of people, sure. You know what I mean? Like on content, or on design, on different stuff. Sometimes, because like I'm not confident with my designs half the time. Like probably in the last 2 years, I designed the AKA cover, the K-Fuss, and then this new hoodie that I designed now, I didn't bring it. But yeah, those are the only two things I designed. Everything else is like, okay, Zaman, what do we do with the pads? And then he comes with the surfboard, it's like, yeah, actually. And then it's like, yo, I wanna do a bike. We just found like a printer now who can skin the whole bike, so it's gonna be like really crazy. Yeah.
Do you think you'd be like someone who taps into like actually like something like product design?
I really do product design.
Like, yeah, I mean like for sneakers. Though.
Sneakers?
Yeah.
Because I worked at the company, I realized how far gone the game is when it comes to that. Like, the sneaker game is like, I don't think I have desires to contribute anything better than what I've had on my shoes. And they still surprise me, you understand what I'm saying? Like, so, like, shoe design definitely. Actually, to answer you with the whole paradox of sneakerhead but dancer. So, I would just like, I want to say it outright, I'm no sneakerhead. So, first of all, you guys need to understand, the sneakerhead is someone who's really crazy about shoes. When I say crazy about shoes, not the shoe, the story behind the shoe. Message. If you're a sneakerhead, you buy two of the same pair, and you wear one, and you keep one as stock, forever. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying? That's a sneakerhead. So a lot of people throw the word sneakerhead around a lot. Yeah. Just because you collect, like as soon as you wear the shoe, it's not collectible anymore, you know what I mean? So you're not a sneakerhead, you're just a collector. A sneakerhead, he buys like three pairs, four pairs. And obviously now the game is crazy, because you can flip the sneakers for like maybe 50K, 100K. So the game of being a sneakerhead is not easy anymore. Yeah. Like back in the day it was easy, now it's not easy. You need bots, you need to hire people to go stand in line for you. Yeah. It's crazy.
Reselling, the whole reselling thing.
The sneakerhead is the reseller. A lot of guys don't get it. Like that's the sneakerhead. Because he knows the story,
he
knows the value, and there's other sneakerheads that want this but they couldn't get it, and that's what the game is. So
that's why he has a new like pair that's not been worn.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of people are taking the reseller like someone else. Obviously, after a lot of people that like money saw that whole game, jumped in. They're the resellers, but the whole thing is based on that.
Yeah.
Yeah, the whole thing, if you're a sneakerhead, that's all you're doing, man. Making sure you've got connections with the guys at the stores. Making sure you're going to get it first. Like, no matter what it takes. You know what I mean? Like, in, you know, some guys will stab you for shoes.
Yeah, straight up.
It's too much.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Just to close it lastly. Mm-hmm. yeah, it's been. But with the music,
yeah,
just want to know.
Hey, you left the mop at home, my G.
The mop,
yeah. But we heard the new single.
Yeah,
it's crazy, by the way.
Thanks.
So it's a wave. When should we? Is there like a date or like an estimate where people like can expect the new project to drop?
Yeah, man. So I was supposed to be done in July already, but we did a Tupac style. We did like 50 something tracks. So I've got like 3 albums ready or so.
Heard it first.
Yeah, man, bunch. I haven't done any interviews, so yeah, definitely premiering.
But yeah, man, hopefully next month or late this month. Next month, let's say next month, it's out.
Next month is
November.
It's for real October.
Yeah. I could have dropped it this month.
Yeah, it would have been crazy.
I don't even know the name of the album. I think the name of the album is Taba the Album.
It's aware. Shut up, bro. I'm a living boozy Pellegrino, but a coffee for a cappuccino. I'm a number and it's a bulletin. I'm a thing and it's a balinese. Tennis and just a paraffin. Snapchat, Pellegrino.